An already saturated Sydney has been drenched again this afternoon with heavy rain and wild winds hitting the city from Penrith to the CBD and north to the Central Coast. The SES has responded to more than 60 calls within an hour. And tonight, Premier Chris Minns is promising to look at every option to prevent future flooding, but warns there's no quick fix.
Warragamba Dam overflowing, but if the Premier has his way, this will be a sight we won't see often in the future.
We're looking at all potential changes, including dropping the maximum allowable level on Warragamba.
The plan, drop the amount of water in the dam to 80% capacity so that when it rains, the risk of a spill and flooding is reduced.
However, I can't consider doing that unless I supplement Sydney's drinking water supply in the meantime.
And to do that, waiting in the wings, the $1.8 billion desalination plant at Kurnell, Chris Minns has floated, doubling its operations to make up the shortfall of water from reducing the level in Warragamba.
Desalinated water is much more expensive than rainwater caught in a dam reservoir. But again, Chris Minns has done no analysis, it would seem.
In normal times, about 80% of Sydney's drinking water comes from Warragamba, while in a drought, the desalination plant can provide only 15% of our needs. But expanding the Kurnell facility could guarantee water supply, while dropping the dam level protects the Hawkesbury from devastating repeat floods without having to raise the dam wall.
The scale of infrastructure being proposed by Chris Minns could cost billions to build and take up to 10 years, and that means telling flood-weary communities they'll have to wait longer to be safeguarded.
Whatever works, but if you don't start, then you'll never have a solution.
We just can't keep doing this time and time again. It's punishing on the mental health and the well-being of Hawkesbury people.
But the Premier's costly and long-term vision could give them hope to cling to.
If this was easy, someone would have done it before today.
In Pitt Town, Liz Daniels, Nine News.
It wasn't just the rain causing problems today, but the wind as well. Amber, how windy did it get?
Good evening to you, Georgie. The southerly buster hit Sydney with force, winds reaching gale force along parts of the coast. Wattamolla, south of Cronulla, recorded a gust of 96 kilometres an hour. Kurnell reached 82 kilometres with gusts of more than 70 at the airport, the harbour and Little Bay. In terms of rainfall, Auburn and Greystanes picked up 25 millimetres with 16 millimetres of rain falling the city, Baulkham Hills and Canberra. Temperatures plummeted 3 to 5 degrees as the southerly hit, but with the wind chill, it felt absolutely freezing for this time of year. At 4 p.m, the airport only felt like 5 degrees, Camden felt like 7, and icy 9 degrees in the city and Canterbury. And it's not the end of the wintry weather. There is a gale force wind warning in place tonight. I'll be back with a full forecast a little later, Georgie.